Themes give you control of the overall look of your mind map in a single, simple setting. This allows you to very easily create great-looking, consistent mind maps. You can easily experiment with different looks for your mind maps. When you apply a theme to your mind map, it will introduce new default color sets and font sets, as well as setting the styles of the topics, callouts, floating topics, connections, and so on. But you'll only see the impact where you have not explicitly overwritten the standard styles with your own custom settings. In other words, if you've changed something, then that change will be honored. To select a theme, you can use the Format Change Theme menu item or click on the theme icon in the toolbar. You'll be shown a list of the available themes like this. What you see is a sample mind map styled using the theme and the default color set for that theme. You can just double-click on a theme to use it. When your theme is applied to your mind map, it changes any default settings but will not affect your custom settings. For instance, if you have chosen a different color set, then it will not change the colors of your mind map when you change the theme. But if you then revert to the default color set, it would use the color set from your chosen theme. Similarly, if you have changed the topic shapes, colors, or fonts, etc., these will be left the way that you have set them. But if you revert to the default, then they will be changed to the theme's settings. There's also a button which allows you to reset the current mind map to the theme defaults. This is particularly useful in two situations. Firstly, if you've been playing around with lots of custom colors and topic shapes and just want to reset everything to the theme settings so as to take advantage of the automatic formatting that comes with the theme system. And the second situation is if you've imported a document, for example, from a Novamind 4 file, and you need to reset the settings so that you can take advantage of the power of themes. Choosing this option will remove all of the custom settings for the map background and all of the custom formatting of shapes, lines, fill colors, children coloring, effects, and connection lines. All are returned to their default values calculated based on the selected theme. You can have different themes on different mind maps within your document. Themes are quite intuitive to use, and you can play around with the settings pretty easily and get a feel for what happens, but I think the more that you understand about themes, color sets and font sets, and the settings that override them, the more effectively you can make use of them. So I'll walk you through the whole thing and show you a detailed example. It may help to think of themes and styling like this. The theme system is comprised of three parts. The first part is the overall layout of the mind map with the topic shapes, layout information, font sizes at the different levels and for different types of item. For instance, it can define all of the styling attributes of the mind map title, the first level, the second level subtopics to as many levels as you want, both in layout, topic shape, connection styles, font sizes, fill colors and line colors, and it can do the same for callouts, shapes and floating topics, and even define different settings for callouts and shapes on first level topics as compared to when they're attached to second level topics and so on. The second part of a theme is the default color set, and the third part is the default font set. You can override the default color set and font set to tweak the theme that's applied to the mind map. The combination of the selected theme, color set, and font set make up the theme as it is applied to the mind map. Themes are extremely powerful and are able to take away the requirement for just about all custom formatting to get a mind map looking great. This means that you can concentrate on the content while Novamind automatically keeps it looking great. So we've mentioned that a theme sets the default formatting for your mind map, but all of the settings are like a hierarchy where the top items have the widest reach but the least power, and the lower level detail you get to, the more power the option has to fix the formatting no matter what, but as you go down the settings affect fewer and fewer topics. So the first level is the overall theme and the color set and font set choices that you can make to modify the theme. I put all of these at the top of the hierarchy because together they make up the theme as applied to the mind map. The second level is the automatic children coloring settings, where you can set up things like rainbow color or array coloring, and children layout settings. And then with just very slightly more power, you have the inherited fill and stroke colors and shape settings. We'll still call them the second level because the only time where they take precedence is where you have both children automatic colouring set up and the inherit fill or stroke setting on the same topic. The children would inherit the fill or stroke as that takes the precedence. The third level is the actual specific settings like a custom position topic, custom fill, custom stroke or shape or text settings. And for any of the custom settings, you only override what you need to override, and all the rest of the settings come through the hierarchy. But to let the themed colouring in particular have more power within the system, you can choose themed colours, so that you can change the overall look of the mind map very easily just by choosing a different colour set. So, for instance, to work out what fill color to draw for a topic, Novamind would go through and say, has the user explicitly set the fill color for this topic? If so, the topic will be drawn in that color. If it was a themed color, the color will be worked out based on the current color set. If the user hasn't explicitly set the color, Novamind looks up the hierarchy of parent topics to see if any of them define a fill color for their children topics, either through the children inherit fill settings or the children automatic coloring. It only looks up the parent hierarchy as far as a call out or floating topic, seeing as you don't want your settings on your main mind map to alter the settings of the children of floating topics or call outs. If the first topic it comes across uses the children inherit fill settings, it uses that. Otherwise, if it finds one that sets children automatic colouring, it will use the colour from that. And if it doesn't find anything that's been overridden from the defaults, it gets the colour based on the theme and colour set. As well as the obvious benefits where you can make the mind map look the way you want by only changing a few settings, the combination of these different levels also means that when you're adding new topics to your mind map, in most cases, they will automatically be formatted the way you want them. And when you reorganize your mind map by grafting topics to different positions, the formatting gets updated automatically, while at the same time, where you really want to take control, you can. So let's work through an example. This mind map has had nothing done to the formatting of any of the topics, with the exception that we have explicitly set all of the topics to be rounded rectangle topics so that we can see the fill color on them all. Everything else is coming from the theme. We've set up a hierarchy of topics and subtopics, and we'll be talking about how the fill color is determined for our special magic topic. We have floating topics, shapes, and callouts, so you can see what the themes do to the different types of elements. As we change the theme, the layout of the mind map changes, and the colouring of our magic topic changes as per the theme settings. The default theme has different colours for the floating topics as compared to the mind map, and a variation of the top level colour as the colour of its subtopics. The business theme leaves the floating topics and subtopics everywhere the same colour, except for the descendants of callouts. The presentation theme makes everything a bit bolder, and as the colours are darker, the automatic text colouring makes the text white. With the rainbow theme, you can see that the floating topic has children that use alternating rainbow colours, while the mind map and callout children use ordinary rainbow colouring, but with different start angles. The simple theme is, as its name would suggest, normally just about everything would be line topics for this theme, but we're not seeing that since we have explicitly set the topic shapes. So let's just go back to the default theme and play around with color sets. Let's choose the business green theme. You can see that the color of the mind map title changes, and the color of the floating topic changes, and their descendants change to the equivalent colors in the other color set. If you think of the color set as a grid with base colors and variations, then if the color used for the topic is color number 5, variation 4, then in one color set this might be a mid-green, and in another it would be a mid-blue. But the whole idea is that the colors go together nicely. So let's revert to the default color set. Okay, so our magic topic is colored according to the theme color. Now let's select the first level subtopic and change the colouring mode to rainbow colouring. As you can see, our magic topic is now inheriting the rainbow colour, But the children of the call-out have not been affected because the effects of children colouring do not jump across floating topics or call-outs. You would have to set it on the floating topic or call-out explicitly to affect its children topics. Now, if we change the theme or the colour set, you can see that none of the subtopics of our rainbow topic are affected. Now, let's select the next level down and choose a fill setting as a themed colour and tell the children to inherit this colour. As you can see, our magic topic is now coloured according to this colour. Seeing as we've used a themed colour, when we change colour sets, it will update to an equivalent colour in the other colour set. So although we've taken control of the colour, we're still letting the colour set have an impact. Of course, if we had chosen an explicit colour, then it would not change no matter what we do with the colour set. So let's do that on the magic topic itself. Now, no matter what we do anywhere else, that magic topic is not going to change its fill colour. Now let's have a look at what happens when we graph topics into different places. This topic has rainbow colouring set for its children, so it will itself get the appropriate colour for where it's grafted, but it will continue to determine the colour for its children. This topic has a colour set for itself and determines the colour of its children, so that will be transferred. And this one doesn't set any colours, so it will get the colours from its new location. And our magic topic is 100% custom fill colouring, so it will not change its colours no matter what we do with it. And finally, let's go back to the old structure and see how to undo each of these custom settings. On the magic topic, you would revert to the default fill colour. Or if you wanted to revert all of the settings on the topic, you could just right-click on it and reset the formatting. On this topic, we could stop it from setting its children colours, or we could just revert to its default fill settings. On this topic, we had set it to automatically colour its children, so we could just revert that to the default. And for the mind map, if we have set a custom colour set, we can revert to the theme by choosing the default colour set. So you can see that the whole theme and styling system is both very powerful and very flexible, taking the majority of the work out of formatting your mind maps.